Hi lovely viewers, it's me again, your one and only Mutati Mpundu. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time on my channel, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel by hitting the red subscribe button down below and turn the bell icon to join the notification squad. Don't forget to like, share and leave a comment. Tell me what you think about this video in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you lovely viewers.
I've not bloody lost, so don't waste my time. I have not lost. How do I accept the word I've not lost? That, those figures were not there in 2006.
So what are you going to do now?
But you are the reporter, ask them.
No, what I'm asking you, what
you are the bloody reporter, ask them. False figures. You are the so-called reporter wasting taxpayers' money here, and you have got these inflated figures on which they say they are closing in. These are fake reports. They were not there in 2006.
Have you spoken to them about these figures then?
I'm giving to you. Go and speak to them. I'm hunting for them. They have run away.
What if you don't find them?
Question. Go and find them. You are a reporter. That's your job.
This bloody BBC, this is not Zimbabwe.
This is what Dan Kalale, Benon Mwanga, and Birekstara can do. And they expect that BBC comes to me. What do you do?
They think I'm in Zimbabwe. You can run down Zimbabwe.
Not to registered voters. They are saying that Rupia Banda is catching up. Rupia Banda is not catching up. They are only catching up in their own imagination.
How does he jump from 300 to 615,000? Because yesterday was 300. How has he jumped from 300 to 615,000?
Because he's won a lot of constituencies. Yeah, they were talking about their stronghold.
Now listen, there is nothing stronghold, because Vubui's registered voters, you cannot get a total vote of 5,000, but Rupia Banda at 9,000. Where is that stronghold? If you take Vubui, simple Vubui, and all the constituencies which they have, all the constituencies they have increased, they don't, MMD has no stronghold. They are only a bunch of thieves. They are only a bunch of criminals. Vubui, there is no way you can get Vubui. There is no way you can get Vubui to get to record 9,000 voters. When there is apathy, when the total turnout is 41%. Now, 9,000 is 41% of what figure? So you calculate yourself. 9,000. And if you say 9,000 is 41%, now what's the 100% figure?
100,000.
Yes. And there is no way Vubu can record that. And they have done that right through in Eastern Province. Right through your Eastern Province. The figures which are in Eastern Province did not exist in 2006.
So the results are not authentic, the ones they are given?
The whole thing, the results, there is nothing. The whole election is not free and fair. Judge Mumba is operating under very difficult conditions because she's surrounded by a bunch of criminals like Dan Kalale. She's surrounded by Dan Kalale, a bunch of criminals, and the man in charge of ITT is the one who is inflating figures. Even the figures which they're coming, that's why you can see the delay in announcing the results. Results, they are taking 18 hours before they come and they announce. The ITT man and Dankar, they're a bunch of criminals.
What are you going to do now, Mr. Sir?
Don't ask me. I've told you what I've done now. I can't be telling you what I'll do tomorrow.
But you're not going to accept these results, sir.
But I've told you, you only accept if you are defeated. And there is no way Rupia Banda can defeat me. If he wants to defeat me, he must defeat me genuinely, not through thieves. Corruption, I'm sorry. Elections in Africa has been marred by corruption.
So we're supposed to get a comprehensive statement from you?
I've given you this figure. Now you follow it up.
Waiting for what? This seat belongs to me, not to him.
President is already
Problem with the media in this country. You see, Kaunda did not only damage the economy, he damaged your heads. And the portals in your head for them to be repaired, it will take another 27 years.
So maybe when the government can send us to school.
No, we don't send you to school. We panel beat your heads. But now let me start. First of all, you are wrong, like anybody else, to say that the tender must be advertised.
Educate me, Honorable Minister.
Two, you are wrong. You are right by saying you pick the best. Now, there are tender procedures. The tender procedure, one, there is a public tender, depending on the time you have. There is a selected tender. The tender board, the tender authority decides. And I would like you to go and tell the Weekly Post that councils in themselves, they are tender authorities. They don't get permission from the central tender board. That's for the central government. Each local authority is a tender authority on its own.
So
two, now wait a minute, I'm trying.
You can get tender from your friend.
Now listen, doesn't matter. Two, they don't need to rely on those people who are registered by public works, as they put it in their paper. Now, how do you go to tender? You see, you don't even have dictionaries to understand the tender. The tender is, before you go to tender, as the tendering authority or the employer, you have your own estimates. And when you have your own estimates, you are going to accept tenders which you think are realistic and nearer to what your estimates are. And that's why on every tender, whether it be government, private, local government, there is a provision or a clause which says it is not necessary to accept the lowest tender.
When Frederick Chilufya decided that he was going to bring our colleague, and me, I said, no, sir, there is no way I can work with this man because I know him. This man, he can't govern. He can't rule. He's incapable. He's politically impotent. Levy did not stand time. Levy was sleeping. The man surprises me. The man confuses me. But I sympathize with him when he went to India, when he was recently treated in India. There is something which the Indians failed because his brain and his mouth, they don't coordinate.
Yes.
Our president has taken on one so-called businessman. One so-called businessman who conned Dr. Kenneth Kaunda. And because he knows Dr. Kenneth Kaunda likes people who are passionate, to convince him, he even became a reverend of preaching for prisoners. That man came to con Frederick Chilufya and said, Frederick Chilufya, I'm going to bring you Carrington Mays, I'll bring you ABCDFG. Today is Mwanawasa's number one financial advisor. he has shares in JW. He has shares in Indola Life. He has shares in KCM in Chingola. But because he doesn't know, Levi doesn't. My chewandingole shirika shirelola. Levi Mwanawasa has to know. He knows whom I'm talking about. And I don't want to mention him here.
That's a panji. You can call him a panji. 5 years as a woman of this month. I knew Zeko, you found the one, you made a panic. Usogoreli si ufumu. Yakuti mwana achokapo, tata achokapo, pilikepo mwana ai. Nga panja aja wala kalibana amu ndala nga kwa nisa umkaju. Wabele sa wesi manipa platform. Aza wawele sa tibwana masitako chani kudu kuchadza.
The post continues to be giving false reports, false rumors. The post is not part of the economic commission, the electoral commission of Zambia. Where did they get the results to say MMD is going to get up to 86? Where, how did they get the information, apart from the information which was fed to them by MMD? And they go again lying, because any experienced politician in the United Kingdom, United States of America, in Europe, anywhere, with an exception of China, where there are no elections, all presidential aspiring candidates must insult the top civil servant, that civil president cabinet. And for them, Gamanisha statement to say, I forced my way. I don't know what Mr. President is all up to. I don't need to force my way. He said, I went there at the reception. I would like to see Secretary of the Cabinet. They cleared me. They escorted me. And I had a discussion with Secretary of the Cabinet. Because one, as a member of the public, as a Zambian, and that's our office. So for them to come and say such a force this way. If I wanted to force my way, I would have forced my way in State House. Why should I force my way into the Cabinet to the office? And if you look there at their report, and you look at government paper, what we expect is the government paper to distort. But the government paper has been very fair, very, very fair. Because, for example, Zambia Daily Mail has been very consistent. The Times of Zambia, for a change, they have changed. They are putting that thing where they are saying MMD and PF in Tigris. But there we have our great Mr. Memo. The only reason why Mr. Freddy Memo is behaving that way, the only way why he's behaving that way, we know he's trying to protect Mr. Mtembochito or Chito brother, because he is attached to Chito brothers, and Chito brothers are involved as private prosecutors, and they have earned more money than whatever they will ever recover from the so-called plunder. Them and Tony Blair's brother, they have earned more money. And because Mr. Mende is learning to be a lawyer there, he has to defend them. He's a trolley. We don't need the post to be the... Where, before Judge Mandela announced the results, where did the post get the figures from? Because they went to bed much earlier than when Judge Mandela was announcing the figures. Where did they get the figures apart from MND? I wouldn't be surprised if they are a party to the rigging. Report accurately. Don't be the judges. Don't be the police. Don't be the prosecutors. And don't be the judge. Report what is on the ground.
and the post. I'm extremely disappointed with Mr. Freddy Mendez and Mr. Amos Mantrengo. They are reporting. I will not be surprised if they are writing these things from Godfrey House, from Mr. Mtembo Chitos. I will not be surprised if the editorials are written from Mr. Mtembo Chitos.
I was a rebel, proper rebel, not like him.
His sense of humor would leave one cracking with lingering laughter. President Michael Sata often cracked jokes regardless of where he was.
And he said, Mike, I'm growing old. I have to retire from accountants. I'm going to buy a farm. I just looked at him. And then he was, because he was living in Kavulonga Road, he had a beautiful house. And then he found this place. I don't know whether he used corruption or what. This place was too big. He brought me here. The first thing he did here without building a house or a toilet was to put an airstrip. Because one thing which I had forgotten to tell you, this man who is here is the first person who taught me to lift an aeroplane and bring it down.
He was a hilarious character in many spheres. Political rallies were no exception.
Imwebwana mwone kamulina mimba na pamaso mwone kalimwokongola kumani mwoyipa nga kumwipa munga imba manje wanani wana baba Yesu anaka mbati osa nilivya neo msirile mweka ndibana wana kote alavana ngatumalaya ngana alavana waone kapu waone kabunga munga niwana ama si Zambia iwone kabose wa ntunyuwana wama si basika na vana wambo kalam kalam mzape za watu mitu hapita kakura sisi kumarigeti siwa siwa na amene anari mwine wa sisi yo akuti wiki
oda
Parliament was never spared.
And Honorable Mr. Speaker, I'm very pleased. There are three ladies representing Madam Vera Chilufya because she used to come here with the big dukes. In Zimbabwe, those who understand Shona like Dr. Piri, there is a Mr. Piri who is Deputy Minister. Se chapindam siso chakaipa, chapindam numbu chakanaka. And when you go to Namwala, they say Mala Zuma, Wata Zuma, Waria Mankomona. We used to enjoy being in this house with some Mzungu MP, because every time when we disappeared, we were smoking outside.
Comedians in Zambia admired President Sata's natural ability to crack jokes.
He had the talent of a comedian because when the president used to have rallies, let's say in Mandevu, it was easy for him to connect himself with the people of Mandevu.
Each meeting that he addressed, there must have been, there should be some comedy. And there's one that I like, which runs on radio through and through. When he was talking about the wage freeze, the one he says, I've said there's no wage freeze. If you talk about wage freeze, Mr. Shamenda, we shall freeze you. And I always tell my wife the same, that I will freeze her if she talks about there's no relish in the house. When there's beans, she wants sausage.
Was a comedian.
And when you go to Namwala, they say, Mala Zuma, Wata Zuma, Waria Mankomona.
Manje wanani wana baba. Yesu anaka mbati osa nilivya neo, msirile mweka ndibana wana. Kote alavana, ngatumalaya ngana alavana waone kapu. Waone kapu nga munga ni wana wama si. Zambia, even in Kavosi, and you want to see.
But in countries, and we must look after our own country, Zambia, which God gave to us. We didn't buy, he gave to us. And if God gave to us, why should one child be sleeping in a furrow? Very much.
If you died today, how would you like the Zambian people to
Zambians to remember me that I spoke for the people of Zambia? I have a talanta kwa alivyo wimbo kila mtu ni talanta yake talanta kulandira kwa balanda kulandira kwa watu wako atotrimba kulandira kwa bantu ba mwensonga iwe bonse mwe basambirira muri ba mwenso sana. You are the worst cowards. All educated people, you can't speak out because you are scared of going to prison. All educated people are the worst cowards. We fought for freedom, but if it is the freedom we fought for, I would have not gone to prison in 1960. Thank you.
Okay, we were here last night. Those policemen have spent the night here. They came here, we chased them, they came, they wanted to pick me at night with us. I'm sorry. But I'm very grateful to the policemen. They were very cooperative, they are very dignified, they are just following orders. So I'm very, very grateful to all the officers who were here, including those who came last night. They were very, 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 very reasonable. That's what we expect. We want you to have a police service, not a police force. But now we will know when we get to the police station. Shall we go to the police station, please? Guy, where is the back? Good morning, gentlemen and ladies. How are you? Thank you for giving me an escort. Hello, Oxen Church. How are you? That's our Oxen Church. I'm just invited. That's one that I hope
Thank you. go back to that. I will apologize. Yes. Respect my apology. Thank
you. We want freedom. We want freedom. We want freedom. We want freedom. We want freedom.
That's the question.
We shall allow the president to answer those questions. Very high, very high.
Anyway, we need microphone here and go and sit down.
The mum nani san has it gone from here?
Mama Bamuzeri. What we are lacking in Zambia, all of you who are here, we are not laughing at you, and we don't envy you. We are not laughing at you, and we don't envy you. For those who have never lived in the United Kingdom, they will probably envy you. But for some of us who have lived here, and when you look at the things you go through, what we need together, we have to change Zambia. Create the opportunities for your children. Because some of you are here because of schools, as that professor said. And we have to change in a number of other things. And I think my program is slightly tight. I will ask my ministers to contribute. I will start with the Minister of Commerce, if he is available. Yes, give him the microphone.
This is DJ Mutati exclusive.
Alright, that's all right for you today, lovely viewers. If you did enjoy the video, please don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about the video you just watched in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you, lovely viewers. Once again, I go by the name of Mutati Mpundu. I love you, peace. I gotta go.